Welcome to part three of the Brightspace Foundations training, where we will dive headfirst into the content tool. If you remember from part one, content is the meat of our course and is where you and your students will spend the most time. Content is where all your course materials, modules, and anything you want the student to learn and interact with will be housed. This is where you will build and organize your course content, and this is where students will access the course material and activities. If we think of the course home as the front door and entryway of your course, content is the living room. Understanding the parts of content. First, on the left, we have the overview, bookmarks, and course schedule. The overview is a space where you can add a welcome message or a course description. Don't put your syllabus here. We will go through where you will add your syllabus shortly. The overview is only seen once by the student, the first time they click on content, and every other time you or your student comes to content, you'll be taken to the last content module you are on. So you can absolutely ignore this section because if it's empty, students don't see it at all. Bookmarks. Bookmarks are personal to the instructor or student. As the student navigates through your course content, they can bookmark topics as desired. This is where they will access anything they may have bookmarked themselves. The course schedule is a view of upcoming due dates and tasks from the built-in calendar. It's a helpful place to get an overall view of what's due soon. However, if you don't add due dates to assignments or activities in the class, then it'll be a pretty empty tool. Beneath that, we have the table of contents. The table of contents contains all of your modules, submodules, and items. It is essentially the outline of your course. A module is a storage place for a group of related course items called topics. You can think of it like a folder for organization purposes. A submodule is like a subfolder within a module to group other related items. And finally, topics are the items, files, videos, links, assignments, and other activities you add to a module or submodule. We will talk more about these on the next slide. Third, we have the content frame in the middle. The links you click on the left will display in the content frame on the right. You will add your content topics, files, and course-related activities here. The modules on the left, under the table of contents, let you access and add content to each section individually. Let's talk more about modules. As we said, a module is a storage place for a group of related course items called topics. You can think of it like a folder. We typically use modules to organize our course content by week, unit, or topic. By organizing your content in a meaningful way, you make it both structured and easier for students to work with. In the example on this slide, we have three modules: the syllabus as its own module, where we will upload the course syllabus, and then we have week one and week two as example modules. The first module or folder you will almost always create will be your syllabus module. To create a module, click on the text that says add a module. Type the module name, in this case, type syllabus, and then press the enter key on your keyboard to create the module. Pause the video here while you create the syllabus module. I also challenge you to add two additional modules called week one and week two. Hint, when you do this, make sure you are using the add a module option on the left and not the add a submodule option that appears in the content frame. Doing the latter will create a module or folder within your syllabus module instead of its own module on the left. Now let's take a moment to understand the module options. Once we create a module, we have the option to add date restrictions or a description. The start date is when the module becomes available or accessible to students. This is optional if you want to control when the module opens. If you don't add a start date, the module will be accessible/visible by default. The due date is when the module is due. This will also show up in the class calendar. Typically, due dates are set on specific assignments or activities rather than on the module itself, so this can also be left blank unless you want students to know when an entire module is due for completion. The end date is when the module can no longer be accessed by students. It may still be visible, but the contents inside will be unclickable and inaccessible from content if the end date has passed. Oftentimes, this can be confusing to both students and faculty. So again, we recommend mostly using date restrictions on specific activities within a module rather than the module itself. That being said, to add a start date, end date, or due date to a module, click on the text that says Add Dates and Restrictions, and then click on the text to add any of the dates you wish. Descriptions are a way to add text to the page which will provide more information to the student about the module. Instructors might include student learning outcomes here for the week, or unit agendas, or a descriptive module overview. Keep in mind, do you remember from part one when we discussed the content browser on the course homepage? If students use the content browser to access content instead of clicking on content from the nav bar, they will not see any information you add to the description on the module. So, if you use the descriptions heavily, make sure you orient your students to how they should navigate your course during the first week. Actually, this is an important thing to do regardless. Every instructor uses Brightspace a little different. It is up to the instructor to show your students how you expect them to navigate your course and where they will find the important items. You cannot assume every student will be able to understand how you laid out your course. There is a plethora of ways to organize a Brightspace course, and students need to be oriented to your way. Don't assume they will figure it out. Lastly, there is an option to hide a module if you want to make it invisible. Click on the eyeball icon to toggle it off, which will hide it from students. You might do this for content that is just for you, that you don't want students to see, or maybe you are still building the content out and don't want to confuse students. Or you might even do this if you like to control the access to a module manually, making it available at your discretion. Keep in mind, even if you hide a module or set an end date on a module, students may still be able to access assignments, discussions, or quizzes from that module by accessing those tools directly from the nav bar. This is also why setting dates on the actual activities is more important than putting date restrictions on the modules. Once we have our modules, we're ready to add our content. First, I will click on the syllabus module I created on the left. Then, I will click on Upload Create and select Upload Files from the drop-down menu. A pop-up window will appear with my choices. Click on My Computer and then click on Upload to open the File Explorer on your computer to select the file to upload. Note, you can upload more than one file at a time, and you can also drag and drop your file or files onto the upload screen instead of clicking upload. Once you've selected your file and it loads in the window, click Add. Your file or files will be added to that module. Here you can see the example syllabus we added to the syllabus module. When you access the file, it will render right on the screen so students don't have to download anything to view it. As a note, if you need to make edits to the syllabus, you will need to make those edits to the original file on your computer and then upload the updated file to Brightspace and remove the old one. That brings us to deleting a file. If you added an item to content that you need to remove, click on the drop-down arrow next to the name of the topic and select Delete Topic from the menu. A dialog box will pop up with two options. Either remove the topic but keep the associated file or activity in the course, or permanently delete both the topic from content and the associated file or activity from the course. Generally speaking, we recommend using the first option, to remove rather than permanently delete, unless you know for certain you want that to be completely deleted out of your course. There isn't a way to undo this in many circumstances. Feel free to pause the video now and delete the file you uploaded. Finally, let's talk about the other options that are available to you under the Upload Create menu. Upload files is what you use to upload documents, PDFs, PowerPoints, etc. Video or audio allows you to add video links or files and embed them so they play directly in Brightspace. You can also use this to add YouTube videos to your course content. Create a file allows you to create a document directly in Brightspace. Basically, you can type words on a blank content page. Create a link is the tool you will use when you want to link out to other material online outside of Brightspace, such as a website they will use for an activity or a link to an article you want students to read. The next one, Add from Manage Files, is used if you have already uploaded a file to the course and you want to reuse it. You can do it again using Add from Manage Files. When you delete a file and select the option to remove instead of permanently delete, that file remains in the Manage Files tool and can be re-added in the course later. Lastly, we have new assignment, checklist, discussion, quiz, and survey. Create assessment activities right from content using these tools. We'll talk more about assignments, discussions, and quizzes in more detail in the next few videos, but these are items that students can interact with or respond to. This is the end of part 3. We encourage you to practice creating modules, adding files, and exploring the different ways to interact with them, such as reordering, moving things around, or deleting things.